The Goalseek function is a great tool that allows you to take any spreadsheet, any model, and tell Excel that you want a certain answer, and Excel is allowed to change one of the input cells. What it does is it eliminates you having to do it manually. So in this example, we've got a little income statement, we've got a gross profit here based on a selling price and a cost of sales percentage. If we're told we have to get gross profit to 250, we could do it this way. So I could go here and try 11. It's 218, not enough. And so I could keep doing this. Or better, make use of the Goalseek tool. To activate the tool under Data, you'll see What If Analysis, Goalseek. What this is asking for is what cell you want to set, so this cell here. What number do you want to make it? So we're going to type in 250. And then Excel needs to know what cell can it change. Must it be that one or this one or these? So we're going to say, look at that cell over there for the set cell. Make it 250. What cell can it change? In this case, we're going to allow it to change that one there. When I say OK, you'll see it runs through, finds a solution, and you'll see it goes down to the 10th or 11th decimal to make sure that it's as accurate as possible. Let's say now your manager comes to you and says, we can never sell it for that price. The most we can get is, for example, 1150, but you still have to make the 250 gross profit. Well, now we're going to run Goalseek again. So we go What If Analysis, Goalseek. I'm going to say that cell there must become 250, but now we're going to change here the cost of sales percentage. So when I click on it and I say OK, you'll see it runs through. It says it finds a solution. So the only way we're going to achieve this is if we get the sales price to 1150 and we somehow drop the cost of sales percentage to the 17.99%. What happens now if you can't change these, but you want to play with the units sold? So I'm just going to go back to the original numbers. So there's the original numbers. We now want to change these, but Goalseek only allows you to change one input at a time. So we need to somehow create a number that can change all these units sold. So the one way to do that is to add a percentage in. So I'm going to say unit sold curve. I'm just going to put 100% in there. And what you'll see, so we could now do this manually, but one of the better ways to do this is, remember, this is working perfectly within the spreadsheet. So what I'm going to rather do is just copy that, put it here, so we've got our original input. And I'm now going to change this to say, look at this input over here and multiply it with that percentage, put my dollar signs on. So at the moment we've done nothing special. Just going to change that color because that's no longer the input. But now what it means is I can do a Goalseek. So let's go Data, What If Analysis, Goalseek. I can say I need that number to be 250, but now I'm going to say you can play with this curve. So if we think sales in month one will go up 10%, then put 10% everywhere. When I say OK, you'll see it gets a solution. It looks like our monthly sales needs to go up 17%. And what it means is instead of 5 units, 5.8. So you can actually see that you can actually make a Goalseek that runs off a whole bunch of numbers if you're happy that it'll be treated in the same way. They'll all go up and down based on the same numbers.